The public land survey system is a surveying method developed and used in the United States. It was prompted by the passage of the Land Ordinance of 1785. The federal government needed a detailed survey system to divide newly acquired land. It is the system that land ownership is based on in most of the U.S. And just to prepare you, this system is interesting. There are not scalable patterns, and there are many times patterns are not consistent. What it has going for it is that it is probably the easiest way to communicate general location on a map. It is not great for detailed location, as you will see, but it is a quick way to get you in the ballpark. The beginning point of the U.S. Public Land Survey is located on the Ohio-Pennsylvania border. See what I mean? Interesting. Not all states adopted the new land survey system, and many of the original colonies continued to use the British system of meets and bounds. There are 37 initial points in the U.S. A baseline runs through the initial point east-west, and the principal meridian runs north-south. The standard parallels run parallel to the baseline. They are 30 miles apart, or 24 miles in some areas. Township lines run parallel to the baseline as well, and they are about 6 miles apart. One problem with the public land survey system is that it is a square grid system laid on a round surface. Adjustments have to be made. Guide meridians run parallel to the principal meridian at roughly 30-mile or 24-mile intervals. The range lines run parallel to the principal meridian, and they are about 6 miles apart. With our township and range lines in place, we are ready to draw in our sections. However, the 6-mile squares aren't perfectly square. Within the township, adjustments are made by starting the sectional survey in the southeast corner and moving progressively towards the northwest corner. This means the northern and westernmost sections are not a full square mile. Sections are numbered in rows starting from the northeast corner and running back and forth to end in the southeast corner. Another problem with the public land survey system is that some markers are just wrong. Survey methods in the late 1700s were primitive, but those original markers are considered law. This means you will see modern-day maps with some grid lines that are far from square. You might be familiar with some concepts of land navigation that are based on the public land survey system sections. The side of a section is 1 mile long. That makes a section a square mile. A square mile is 640 acres. A quarter of that is 160 acres, and a quarter of that is 40 acres. So a quarter-quarter of a section is 40 acres, you know, like the back 40? Look on a map with satellite imagery, and you can often see square sections marked out with harvest boundaries and forested areas with a mix of ownership. Now, have you heard of a chain when communicating distance? A chain is 66 feet. There are 10 chains in a furlong, and 8 furlongs in a mile. So that means there are 80 chains in a mile, which of course is also the same distance as the side of a section. That means if you know how many paces it takes for you to go a chain, then you can also map a distance by counting your steps. So how do you describe a location using the public land survey system? To describe section 13 shown, you would write it as Township 1 South, Range 12 East, Section 13, MDM, where 1 South is the first township line south of the initial point, 12 East is the range line east of the initial point, Section 13 is the 13th section within that township, and MDM is Mount Diablo Mountain, the name of the initial point. The name of the initial point is often left off since people are usually communicating to someone who has a general idea of where they are. As mentioned before, the sections can be further divided by breaking them down into quarters and quarter quarters. To describe a location in a quarter quarter or 40 acre section, officially, you would write it as the southeast quarter of the southwest quarter of Section 13, Township 1 South, Range 12 East, MDM. The order that we write these pieces in starts with the smallest measurement and then it zooms out. Here's the recipe. If the radio cuts you off halfway, though, we'll never locate that 40 acres. You may also hear a location described in a different order as Township, Range, and Section first, and then the quarter quarter of the quarter. And you will notice that the finest scale you can get to is a 40-acre piece. It's amazing that we are still using this, isn't it? Well, we are, and it is somehow still useful and common for communicating location, even with all this funniness. Let's do one more example. Let's say you're trying to tell someone where a water source is, but you're not there. This area has Boise as the initial point, and you can find that in the legend of the map. The township is 17 north, and the range is 7 east, which you can see by looking around on the side of the squares. The section is 11. The water source is in the northeast quarter of the northwest quarter. So you would communicate the location of the water source as the northeast quarter of the northwest quarter of section 11, township 17 north, range 7 east, Boise. Alternately, you might say the water source is located at township 17 north, range 7 east, section 11, the northeast quarter of the northwest quarter. And that's it!